You know, we hooked up with the Side 3 Productions team. We worked with them for years, and to really put together the right story, the right quality of product that we were going to need to get out there in the marketplace. Jack Creamer, the director of the video, Adelio Lombardi.
The man, the myth.
The ugly myth.
just really brought a nice value to what we were up to.
Why do we spend so much time on this guy's video?
We had Wayne Hollowalla out here from Baltimore, Maryland, and he's my media consultant, and so it's his job to make sure that I'm looking cool and that we're doing all these things. And it's great right here making a video, we're doing work, but just the fellowship amongst friends, family, and business people, really, you know, to generate that, the familyness, I guess, inside our camp was really cool. Familyness? The frick is that, dude? Oh, Lord have mercy. I can hardly wait. I Need You song was actually originally produced by Darren Pianoman Whittington, who's one of the best producers, or has been recognized to be one of the best producers in the industry. So, you know, we thought it'd be real cool if we plugged him in the video, man. And so, you know, we brought him here from New York.
Almost.
Seemed like a million takes just for him to time up his words. Should I do it like this? Should I do it like this? That was pretty funny. You know, so we have this, you know, we're supposed to be looking like this stranded guy walking in trying to find himself, and we have this black bag, and I don't even know what we stuffed in there.
Hollowalla, he was just like, what is he doing with that bag?
And it ended up looking like this body in this bag, and so we had to fold it up, and I was carrying that thing anywhere.
We rode him on the body bag. Yeah.
It reminded me a lot of that Something About Mary movie where the guy's talking about 7-minute abs. He's got that body bag with him.
We were clowning, and he was like, what is he doing with that bag? You know, what? Why is he carrying that bag around?
But it became known as the dead guy.
Nobody's seen that bag in a while.
I haven't seen that bag. We had this guy following us around the video, and I even think we saw that guy up, you know, 5 blocks over.
So he was like, can I be in the video? You guys shooting a video here?
He was always trying to find a way that he could walk in the background, peek around the pillars.
Look. He's trying to get in the video. He's trying
to... Oh, no.
That was fun.
Okay.
He's known as the guy who didn't make the final cut, man. The third day, we did some in-studio shots.
Christella.
She's the best makeup artist in town.
Yes, the illusionist.
And that was kind of fun, just to have that whole thing going on, doing the makeup and doing it real.
She's gonna make Daniel look good.
You gotta be an illusionist to make that happen.
Christella made me look pretty.
He liked that makeup just a little too much.
So now we're makeup all the time.
Oh my God, airport was crazy.
We find this back road where the traffic isn't that crazy and the mountains are in the background. It was just the most beautiful shot.
Like 100 yards.
As we come to find out, this back road ended up being on government property. And so we kind of got bum rushed by security for a minute.
We're shooting a video?
I'm sorry, unfortunately, we can't do this here. It's actually federal property. That's DIA, Denver International Airport.
We had to sit there maybe an hour and a half, 2 hours, dealing with Curtis. What's up, Curtis?
What are you guys doing here today?
You know, he was calling in the sheriffs and all sorts of stuff. And
I'm like, okay, Curtis, what's going on? Can we do this, you know?
Ended up making a relationship with the guy, and he even got in on the video, and he keeps calling us and want to know when it comes out. Ended up working out very, very nice.
Praise the Lord.
Everybody ready?
So when we finally get the clearance out at the airport, it was a cold, cold morning, and it was, you know, we're out there and the wind's blowing, and we keep having to have this car drive up and pick me up and drive up and pick me up.
Thanks a lot.
That was awesome. Just my dead body won't bend.
Who knows? Maybe I never did make it. Yeah, I'm still out there. We ended up shooting back in at another studio, a buddy of mine's house. He has a studio in there. We had a really neat bedroom to use for the shot.
So he was about to kneel down and pray or do something for the scene, and I just ended up jumping out from behind the bed.
Yes, sucker.
They thought that was pretty funny.
It was funny.
Yes.
We end up at Jefferson High School to shoot, you know, some of the video with the kids, and we work with the Positive Spin Foundation. That, you know, it's a program that's set to work with at-risk kids, inner-city kids, and so we connect with that through a fellow by the name of Robert Hawkins, who founded that. And he's, man, this guy is just so awesome for the kids, you know, and he sets it all up for us. You know, he gets us to school. So we show up at the school, and I'm thinking we're just gonna do this acting thing. I'm all, you know, dressed and ready just to walk in and, you know, wave my hands around and pretend like I'm teaching a Bible study. Well, I walk in there and we end up actually giving a Bible study to these kids.
And there was a scripture in there that said his wife would actually look through the window and watch him and like be embarrassed of him and like actually despise him from himself.
I mean, they were really doing a Bible study there.
And to really, you know, see them get excited to be in a video and to make an impact, that was really cool.
I saw this thing on the thing up there about city.
Great, I'm Adrian. You welcome.
I mean, he wanted to get us in. He wanted to get myself in, Robert, you know, Jack Winnett, and I didn't care. You know, I didn't care where they're going, but he wanted to get us in there. So he figured in the last shot, he'd come in the office and shake our hands. I thought I looked kind of funny in the video, but maybe you should blur me out.
It was pretty funny because my wife was really nervous to be on camera. So it was kind of adorable to watch her, like, you know, like the way that she would get up and walk over.
Hi, how are you? Got a boyfriend? I think I can kick his face in. All right.
Just flirting back and forth, and you know, that was really special just to even get her involved, but that was a good time. Well, that is some behind the scenes footage on the making of the Daniel James I Need You video. So without any further hesitation, let's go check it out.
I need you. I need you.
that I do, I can't do without you, Father. There is nothing that is good that is in me that is not you. I need you so much.